The Lazy Boy Who Learned to Try. Once upon a time, there lived a boy named Toby. Toby was a very lazy boy. Whenever someone asked him a question, he would always say, "I don't know," even if he did know the answer. He just didn't want to bother thinking or trying. One day, Toby's teacher asked the class, "What is the capital city of our country?" Toby, as usual, lazily replied, "I don't know." The teacher sighed and said, "Toby, you need to start trying. You won't learn if you always say you don't know without even thinking." But Toby didn't listen. He continued his lazy ways, saying, "I don't know," whenever he could. One day, during a school field trip to a nearby farm, Toby's class stumbled upon a riddle written on a signpost at the entrance. "I speak without a mouth and hear without ears. I have no body, but I come alive with the wind. What am I?" Toby glanced at the riddle, but felt unmotivated to even attempt an answer. He slouched his shoulders and said lazily, "I don't know, and I don't really care." His classmates started to work together, thinking and discussing possible answers. They wished Toby would at least try to solve the riddle with them. As Toby's class struggled to solve the riddle, they couldn't find the answer no matter how hard they tried. Just when they were about to give up, a gentle breeze passed through the farm, causing the tall grass to sway and the leaves to rustle. Suddenly, one of Toby's classmates jumped up excitedly and shouted, "I know the answer. It's an echo." Toby's eyes widened in surprise. He hadn't even noticed the wind or thought about how it related to the riddle. His friend's answer made perfect sense. In that moment, Toby felt a little bit sad. He realized that by not trying, he was missing out on the fun of discovering new things. He wished he had joined in and been more active instead of always being lazy. As Toby stood thinking, his teacher came over with a smile. "Toby," she said kindly, "I've noticed something special about you today. You may not have solved the riddle, but you've solved something much bigger, the importance of trying." Toby looked up at his teacher, feeling encouraged. "You have a spark inside you, Toby," the teacher continued. "From this moment on, promise me that you'll always give things a try, even if they seem tough or boring at first. You never know what wonders you might discover." Toby nodded. "I promise, teacher. I'll try my best from now on." His classmates cheered for him. Together, they started their next adventures, knowing that trying was the first step to fun and success. Don't forget to subscribe and join us on our next adventure. Todbay Tales, where the fun begins.